In El Salvador, the missing are being unearthed. Crime is a daily occurrence here, but it's the rate at which bodies are being discovered that's cause for alarm. San Salvador's forensic labs, where remains are painstakingly reconstructed, haven't been this busy in years.
In the last month, forensic scientists here have discovered 31 bodies in 21 different sites, and that's just in one neighborhood controlled by one gang. 2 years ago, a truce was declared here, but despite that, the list of missing Salvadorians continues to grow.
But this is now a politically sensitive issue, and new investigations have, for now, been stopped. The Attorney General's office says it's a matter of resources being diverted to the upcoming election, but this forensic lab's director says that's not true.
We feel frustrated because we are scientists who help to solve crimes. And for reasons that have nothing to do with scientific work, we have had to stop. We're disgusted that all of this is only for statistical reasons, where the aim is to show fewer deaths and fewer missing than there actually are.
The truce between the 18th Street Gang and their rivals, MS-13, has been credited with drastically reducing the murder rate, and social programs like this bakery have been successful. But there have been accusations of collusion between politicians and gang members to keep the real numbers of murders down, and some say the truce is simply propaganda.
They talk a lot about us. They say things about a truce, but it's a lie. Just listen to the president and you know he's lying. He's making things up.
But there are people here trying to make a difference. Antonio Rodriguez is a priest who works with San Salvador's youth, who are in constant danger of being forced to join gangs or deal drugs.
I want children and young people to have dreams, and in this country, there are no dreams. I wish for the young to want to live, but all they want is to die, to live or to kill.
But his efforts haven't gone unnoticed by El Salvador's gang members, and he's been told he's now a marked man. For his own safety, Father Antonio is leaving until the election is over, a sign of just how powerful and unchecked gangs here are. And Igalica Aldezura, San Salvador.